Creating effects in Fusion in DaVinci Resolve 20 is easy. It really is. I'm going to show you how you can create super cool text effects like this, for example, or this, in literally a few minutes. Now, mastering Fusion in DaVinci Resolve 20, that's not so easy, but that's exactly why I'm making this video, because I know that a lot of beginners find Fusion overwhelming. I mean, I still find it overwhelming sometimes. But anyway, the problem is that when you find something overwhelming, you avoid it, right? And so by showing you that you can get great looking results real quick and fairly easy, I hope to inspire and motivate you to just dive into Fusion and start. Because that's how you learn this stuff. You start with something simple that gives you a nice result, and then you go from there, step by step. Okay, here we go. So first I want to show you that there are two ways to create these effects in Fusion. First, in the edit page, you can right click on a clip and then turn that clip into a Fusion clip. Then go to the Fusion page and you'll see two nodes already, media in and media out, see? And the media in node is basically your original footage, the original clip, and the media out node is what the result will look like. And you can put each node in its separate viewer. So make sure that you have the split viewer enabled here, and then when you click on the left black dot here of the media in node, it will turn white, and that means that the media in node is now visible in the left viewer. Click on the right dot of the media out node, and it will be visible in the player on the right. And now, for example, with the media in node selected, you can add a text node and it will appear in between the media in and out node. Just type some text. And of course, you can also manually connect and disconnect nodes. Just click on the connection to delete it and click and drag between nodes to connect them. And so between the media in and out node, you can build your effects. Here in the left viewer, you see the original footage, and then in the right viewer with the effect, in this case, just some text. And so that's how you can build effects. For example, if you want some glowy text, select the text node, hit shift plus spacebar to show all the effects, and then look for the soft glow effect. Add it and boom, glowy text. But then there's also a second way to create an effect. In the edit page, if this is your footage, for example, you can also go to effects here and then drop a Fusion composition clip on your footage. Then go to Fusion, and you'll see now that there's no media in node, only a media out node. But if you add text and you connect it to the media out node, type some text, you can see the text appear on a transparent background. And so if you go back to the edit page now, you'll see that the text will be there on your footage, but it's on a separate video track. So two ways to create these effects, depending on what you're going for, one might be better than the other. Okay, and now let's create some effects. First, particles. Everyone loves particles, right? Except for your computer maybe, because it requires a lot from your computer and the GPU. So make sure you know how to use the render settings to make everything go a little bit smoother. I'll link a video in the description. Okay, so first of all, in the edit page, add a Fusion composition clip on your footage. That's the first step. And then make it as long as you want the effect to last. A few seconds will do. Then go to the Fusion page, and here we're going to add a few nodes to create the particle explosion effect. First, add a text node and connect it to the media out node. Type some text. Great, we have text. Then with the text node selected, hit shift plus spacebar and look for the P image emitter. Add it, hit shift plus spacebar again, and add the P turbulence effect. Hit shift plus spacebar again, and add the P render node. And make sure everything is connected like this. And then you should already see some stuff happening when you move the playhead. And now it's literally a matter of tweaking the settings to make the effects look like you want it to look. But I'll show you the most important ones to get you started. So first select the emitter node and go to style and set it to blob. And then here in size, increase the size until the text looks normal. Then go to controls and increase the random seed to, well, basically whatever you want. And of course you can come back later to change it again once we get the effect going. Then go to velocity and increase the velocity variance. And now you can see it, right? Particles. And this is what it would look like without that turbulence node. See, it would just go in a straight line. So the turbulence node makes it look cooler, right? But the effect is a bit slow now, so let's also increase the velocity. Only problem now is that the particles go to the right instead of exploding in all directions from the middle. But you can fix that by setting the Z angle to -90. There we go. Look, it already looks really cool, right? And in the turbulence node, you can customize how the particles explode. For example, increase the Y strength for a more vertical spread. But of course, this is just a start. You can now customize and tweak the effect even more by adjusting the color over life, for example, which will change the color of the particles over time. You can also add more nodes, like soft glow, to make it look like this. And so now it's totally up to you to experiment and learn. Okay, now before I show you the second effect, maybe you're already tired of it. That's fine. Maybe you just want cool text effects in seconds and not minutes. Well, then maybe you should check out MotionVFX, the sponsor of this video. Because instead of in 5 minutes, plugins for MotionVFX allow you to create incredible text animations and motion graphics instantly. All their plugins are also super easy to install with their free app M-Installer, and then just drag and drop the effects or titles on your timeline, and done. And they're adding new effects all the time. Check out these new plugins, M-Music Video 3, or maybe you want it a bit more stylish, M-Style Old Money. Looks super cool. And guys, just because something has music video in its name doesn't mean you have to use it for music videos. I mix and match all the time. So definitely go check them out. The link is in the description, but maybe wait until tomorrow because then they have their DaVinci Resolve anniversary sales. So if you're looking for big discounts, tomorrow. Okay, and now back to DaVinci Resolve and the text effects. 3D rays. Again, drop a fusion clip on your timeline and go to fusion. Then hit shift plus spacebar and add a 3D text node. Add another node, the renderer 3D. And make sure they're connected like this. Then select the text node and type some text. And there you go, we have text. Okay, now let's make it a bit more interesting. Let's make the text outline only, for example. So go to shading, uncheck use one material, set the color to black and alpha to 0. And the text is gone, but don't worry, just go back to text and then extrusion here. Set the bevel depth to 0.0001 and then increase the bevel width to whatever you want. And now we have outline only. And of course, you can change the color if you want here in shading, bevel material. Okay, then let's add the light rays. Super simple, select the renderer node, hit shift plus spacebar and add a rays node. And boom, instant light rays. And now let's make it move. So select the 3D text node, set the playhead here at the start, go to the transform tab and make a keyframe for the Y rotation by hitting the little diamond so that it turns red. Then move the playhead to the end and adjust the Y rotation. And a keyframe will automatically be made. And now the text moves. But see, the rays aren't moving with the text, so it looks a bit weird. But again, all you have to do then is make the rays move. Exactly the same process. So select the rays node and then make a keyframe for the center position, playhead at the start, then move the playhead to the end and change the center position of the rays. And now you get this cool 3D rays effect. And that's it. That's how easy it is to get a cool looking effect. Now, like I said, mastering everything and doing everything without following a tutorial, that's more difficult. But when you get a good result fairly easy and quickly, you know, it makes it easier to just dive into it and start learning. Well, at least I hope it does. Now you can just experiment yourself, adjust the settings, add more nodes, go watch other tutorials and apply what you see there to these examples, for example. You can do whatever you want, as long as you do it. You learn by doing. Just do it. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.